Intercon is a story by Rob Tappert.
I needed a story in a hurry that was small and had no fights in it. And at the time, I had this idea for Gabrielle going home and finding out that her parents had been murdered.
Now, Gabrielle walks out, and she walks a good distance from the house and comes to a stop. Not yet. The rain comes at a precise moment. And then Xena hangs back and then comes up and says...
Gabrielle, I'm sorry.
My niece may still be in that harem.
We'll start out first thing in the morning. If she's there, we'll get her out.
Not only Sarah.
What does that mean?
It's revenge.
It stops the rain.
Excellent. It will have, blood. Blood will have blood. Eli said...
Don't talk to me about Eli. Forgiveness. No, wait, really. That bastard murdered my mother and father. Now I kill him.
Fair enough, too, Gabrielle.
That's just, I get it to be the big time. I just think that's, over to you, really, that one. I tried to, we worded it.
Yeah, I
to
think
you
I just
scope.
Need to take out the need to. But
yeah, sure.
But
it's really, it's like, yeah. Don't even come near me with that stuff.
Yeah, no, it's
cool.
It's
great. Gabrielle's going to walk like, half a football field away from the house in a huge motivational kind of tracking shot. And you're the one that's powerful enough to follow. And I don't know how I can get Eve all the way out. I mean, it just would look a bit clunky to me. But I'm sure we can...
So what is it now we just leave out with the Eli line?
It'll have blood, they say.
Maybe you could add... If you add a Gabrielle in there, it'll have blood, they say. Gabrielle, blood will have blood.
Yeah.
And then she says, don't try and... I mean, that will motivate to say, don't try and...
This bastard murdered my mother.
Yeah,
that's
my... Yeah. She's talking about blood. I'm saying that bastard murdered my
father. Yeah, yeah,
you
yeah.
You gotta talk to me about forgiveness.
Don't talk to me about the consequences. Nice. Don't talk to me about consequences, maybe. Because that's what the speech is. Blood will have blood.
Okay.
Don't talk to me about consequences.
Okay.
Okay, well, we'll work that out. All right. We can do it. Cool. Eve's line.
Nothing's worse than Gurkhan. For her to say you're wrong, nothing's worse than Gurkhan. This girl's just been to hell and back, literally, or, dealing with celestial evil, spiritual evil. Gurkhan's just some stinking warlord. It starts to rate the adventure. This is like a 4 on your danger scale.
You know what? I could... What I think we can do, from an acting point of view, I think we could go, if you... Gabrielle could still say, if you're trying to scare me out of this mission, ... and hold the moment, you two look at, and Eve maybe just, without saying anything, just, and walk off. You know what I mean? We could make that beat play.
It's actually scarier.
It's scarier. Yeah, it's...
Much.
And then she says, Eve. No?
Michael, do you think that says nothing's worse than Gurkhan? Because I'm worried that if we don't tell...
That Gurkhan's really bad.
I think Lucy was just making a point that Eve has been through spiritual hell, the likes of which, in the last 3 episodes, the likes of which Gurkhan isn't. So are we, it is dramatic to say this, but are we actually making a...
Well, what if it's
an overstatement?
What if Gabriel's saying, if you're trying to scare me out of this mission, and Eve says something like, I'm just telling you, Gurkhan is bad. I mean, or Gurkhan is,
You know what?
Way more than you know.
We can probably find a line just telling you...
You know what? You can nest it, or if you want to do it in an actory kind of way, as long as you sell that.
Oh, so, okay, well, I'm sure we can come up with something that is pretty, I'm just telling you that...
High stakes.
Yeah, it's high stakes.
Yeah, you definitely have to keep it
scared. Okay.
I have to be scared, don't I?
Oh, yeah. She needs to leave you with that.
Kind of, yeah.
Chilled at the end.
Well, I'm sure that... Okay. Between us all, we'll come up with a look scary line. There we go. Okay, cool.
Real scary line.
Scary actory line.
Yeah. Right. Okay.
Actory line.
They turn on the lights, they turn on the heaters. But at 5 o'clock in the morning, they can't turn on the sun. And this is how a day on Xena begins. First up, breakfast. Everyone's always asking about Lucy's hair extensions. They used to weave them in individually, which lasted longer, but as she noted rather plaintively in an interview, no one could run their fingers through her hair. Now, as you will see, they snap on and off. I wonder why they never ask male actors about their hair extensions.
Really?
Lipstick.
Yes.
What am I wearing today? What am I wearing every day?
She makes a blend of
honesty and avarice. I always mix them together because I get bored with using the same one. So.
Look how much freedom and creativity she has in her job. I get to mix these two almost identical colours.
To you,
see,
yeah.
Otherwise, the most stressful jobs in the world are ones with low creativity and ones where people are under time constraints or quotas, like chicken sexing or doing Lucy's makeup. So this is how she lifts it above chicken sexing in a factory. She breaks out sometimes and she puts in like 60-40 of avarice to honesty, when really it ought to be 50-50 by rights.
Who's rights?
Avarice, honesty.
Magenta brown.
Hang on, where's Killamore? Where's Killamore? That's a good colour. Killamore! You know, political editor John Armstrong finds Face the Nation better fare than fast food interview programs, but still has a beef.
As for the infamous Xena Tan, see what Lucy has to say about that.
Yes, you too can have the Xena Tan. If you just buy Viziora by Christian Dior. What am I wearing these days? A four?
Four.
I used to wear a five when Xena was a bit darker.
You were a six.
I was a six, my lord.
Gone down two shades.
Yes, we've paled me out because I just couldn't stand having that filthy brown stuff on my sheets every night. Because it takes some washing to get it off. Now it's just a kind of a blush.
It's just... What's happened to your
little dog? Oh, I don't know. He's just... has the run of the household. We don't see him much anymore, you know.
Yeah. What time did you get here? Do I even ask?
Hey, do you want somebody to adopt your dog?
No, I love my dog. My dog doesn't love me, though. I'm just never around, so he basically runs the house. He's like, who are you? As he opens the door and we come in.
Do you live here?
Phoebe.
Phoebe. Yeah, hurry up and
really nice. This is what we have for breakfast. I do. I just met with this nutritionist over the weekend, so she was recommending porridge because you get protein. So I'm not getting enough protein. I'd be glad to share it with you.
What have you got on it? Have you put any sugar on it?
Mm-mm. It's quite sweet on its own. See? It's quite appetizing, actually.
You have
little raisins.
Sugary raisins.
Yes, you do.
Who's Gurkhan opens with Xena, Gabrielle, Eve, and Virgil on the road to Podidia. They've jumped 25 years into the future, and Gabrielle's worried if anyone will remember her. Check out the pre-Mycenaean version of the computer-controlled camera.
I'm helping.
Well, we'll know soon enough.
You're right, Xena.
I'm gonna go ahead.
Right.
I'm Xena.
Oh. Really gonna like you.
Laughter from the crew as we were filming the previous shot made us turn the camera around to find Lucy attempting to marry off this fine, eligible bachelor. Any takers?
In your time.
Lucy's armor is put on before every scene and taken off when they're done shooting. I noticed it's carried around in a small ice chest. There's no ice in it, though. I checked.
Spraying hairspray everywhere. All over the place. Big way.
Didn't anybody just hear what Carmen said?
We never listen to Carmen.
Alrighty.
Pay no attention. In this episode, you should be looking for the yams in every shot. That's the secret. There's a yam in every shot.
I decided if I was going to visit Xena's horses, I'd travel the old-fashioned way.
Which horse is this?
This is Tilly. Tilly is about 12. Uh-huh. Zena's horse.
Right.
The main horse that Zena rides. There's a real relationship between Lucy and Tilly. Lucy trusts Tilly, and Tilly is just the perfect horse for her to ride. So it's a great partnership.
And who's leading Barbie?
Bex. Bex is our Zena riding double, uh-huh. And has been for the entire series.
And how old is Barbie?
She's actually about 17 now, which in horse years is getting on a little bit.
And what does Barbie do?
Barbie is our nodding double. She nods, she counts, and she rears.
And who are we meeting next?
This is Mac.
Right.
And Trisha.
And Trisha, who is?
Trisha is our Gabrielle riding double.
Right. Mac's a very big horse.
He's a very round horse.
Round horse.
Yes. Yeah. And he's actually a quarter horse cross. Oh. And in breeding, he's about 16 uh-huh. years old now. He's jumped fire, and he's particularly good with things like wind machines, scenes with leaves and things, and Max, great.
When they finally arrive at Gabrielle's old home, her fears about her welcome are growing stronger. Meanwhile, Lucy's playing vocabulary games with Greg.
Okay. Penumbra.
You can build that. Thing.
Holy fright, what is penumbra?
Penumbra is like a shadow around someone.
Oh.
Were you lying when you said that you were at Webster's? Would you have known what penumbra was?
I told him I wrote Webster's dictionary. He was asking me all the books I've written. And the fact that I didn't know penumbra was, it was a problem for him.
The days are long, and it was really nippy when these outdoor scenes were shot. Lucy treated the crew to French fries, which she happily ran around handing out.
Hi, Willa. Where are you going?
Sharon. Oh, just in here to get made up, older, This is me before.
Right. I'm only 25 years older when you come out.
Yeah. It's right. Exciting. Not many girls get to do that in a day's work, I tell you.
Tail sighting.
The one. Very, very nice. That told me everything.
Take two tail sight for
So good. I know that people, when they see the shows, all they see is the actors. And what they don't realize is that there are at least 40 other human beings with full lives and personalities that the minute the camera's not rolling, we're back to being with them and with our friends. And this is the reason why Renee and I never get too big for our boots, because there's these wonderful human beings working really hard, and we respect them so much that we know we're just one cog in the machine.
Gabrielle has just found out her parents were murdered, and Renee is discussing her reaction with Michael. This was a really emotional scene, and you can see Lucy giving Renee space as she works on it. Both Lucy and Renee have talked about the emotional space an actor sometimes needs to prepare for a scene. As Lucy plays YMCA with one of the crew, she notices Renee's concentration, and you can see her move the game away.
I gave away a helicopter for a rain machine. And in the end, it's far more dramatic. As Renee decides that she's going to embark on a course of vengeance, the skies open and the rain. It's quite Shakespearean, really. And as she decides to sort of wage mortal war on her own soul, she gets drenched and kind of, I find it very dramatic.
Zena, my niece may still be in that harem. We'll go after her first thing in the morning. If she's there, we'll get her out. Zena, this is not just a rescue mission. I want vengeance! Have blood, Gabrielle. Blood will have blood! Don't talk to me about consequences, Zena! That man murdered my mother and father! Now I kill him!
The rain scene was big and complicated, and it gave us a chance to see just how efficiently the crew works together. I'm always amazed at the fact that I never hear anyone giving instructions, yet everyone seems to know what to do.
I want vengeance!
You're in trouble at this spot. That looks like it's raining to me.
Crikey, that was cold.
Fantastic. Now, you may have felt that was over the top, but the whole thing's over the top, though.
Thank
you very much.
I don't think
you're going
for it.
It's
fantastic. Oh, good. Thank you.
Thank you.
Morning. It's a bra brick moonlit nicht the nicht, isn't it?
Okay.
All right.
Can you tell us a little bit about Rob's Folly? I gather it was made from something else?
Yeah, we actually bought a used barge and then built the superstructure onto the top of it. So we needed something that would be very stable for shooting, and we also needed something that would be big enough. And, you know, it's very hard to, especially in this part of the country, go and find a period boat that you can use. So we had to basically build it from the ground up, and something that we could then also build camera platforms and everything else on to make it work properly. But yeah, it was probably 3 or 4 years ago we built it. It was, you know, another one of Rob's harebrained schemes. Yeah, I want to build a boat. And we all went, oh, God.
The fisherman wants a boat, yes.
Exactly. As long as, and he even had us install it with a couple of those little poles at the back so you can stick fishing poles in. I don't think he's ever used them, but they're there, yes.
Casual sea legs.
High up.
You coming too?
No.
It's interesting, this boat, we were in the middle of the bay, you've got shots of it, you know, it was beautiful, it was just so beautiful, and this in the harbour it was all open and gorgeous, and so you're standing on this boat with all the space, and then you realise that the boat itself is tiny, and the space is at a premium, and actually I found it really intense working, hot sun, nowhere to go, all the gear having to be moved all the time, as you will have seen. And so it was great, and it'll look fantastic, but it was the most tiring day of all so far.
You've got a new outfit on.
Yeah, it's my WWF wrestling outfit now, Gabrielle. It's actually red velvet. I think it reads quite differently on camera. Apparently it absorbs the light. But they were looking for something that would have a textured material like leather, but softer than leather, so that's why they went with a cloth. Just looking to soften Gabrielle a bit and make her a little more feminine. It's a very similar style, but it's just a cloth. It's a different color. Rob specifically wanted to bring back a colorful side of Gabrielle as opposed to the brown leather. Yeah.
Blend in a little bit.
Yeah, it was a little too similar to Lucy's.
Is it as comfortable?
Oh, you know, I mean, it's short. I don't know if it's comfortable. No, it's everyone laughs because it seems as if my costumes get shorter and shorter, but I'm swearing that it's very similar.
That's what your mom says, right?
Oh, no, it's all the gang here. They just go, man, you know, put some clothes on.
Has it got the shorts on underneath, which you mentioned about the old one? You said they were orange.
This is an actual skirt, so I do have something underneath. So that when I'm fighting, I have a bit of modesty, you know? But, yeah, we haven't actually filmed any fight scenes yet, so we'll see. Yeah. But, yeah, so anyway, there you go. It's all silver. They like this silver theme with Gabrielle. So, yeah, similar tie. Freedom in the arms, you know, it's one thing I'm looking for the punches.
How do the size fit into the boots?
The boots are strapped up and along the front. Give my wounds here. They come in through the side. The finely weaved leather bit right here, you can see. One man spends hours weaving all this leather together. They go there and then you just have an opportunity to pull them right back out.
Yep. I think it's strong if you know, today I'm not an assassin. Inferring that tomorrow I will be.
So do I need to make that strong?
Well, today I may not be. It's the line.
As Renee settles in for the take and concentrates on the emotions she needs for the next scene, you can hear the activity going on around that she will need to block out. Notice the small gesture at the beginning when she motions to someone in her line of sight.
Shooting!
7, take 2, marking AMB cameras, common.
Mark.
Mr. Captain, could you shuffle to your left, just a sensation?
Thanks, Bill.
Thank you, that's great.
And Adrian, just a half step back, please. Thank you.
Yes, I'm not called Mark.
Yeah.
Mark.
Set.
And action. Why were you in Mogador?
I was selling slave girls. Amazons I'd captured in a raid up north.
Knows what I know. There's nothing you can do to change the past. You can only work to make the future better. That's why she's so worried about what you might do once you're inside Mogador. Gabrielle, you're not an assassin.
You're right, Xena. Today I'm not an assassin. Tomorrow.
Xena moves to descend the stairs. Oh, Muhammad on action.
Oh, I see.
One of the things the fans are always asking about is the costume. And they're all out there making their own. They want, so we thought we'd give them a close-up view of it. Can you point out various parts?
These are my big old boots, which have got, you know, Nikes on the inside. And though the new costume designer would love to change them and make them look sleeker and make them look better, these are the most functional for what we need to do for fighting. You know, in the fifth season I had those black boots and they were, they might have looked good, but they were just awful to work in. I couldn't run, but being pregnant I didn't run very much. So, the old knee pads, again, very functional. I'd love to make them sleeker, and they may well streamline those this season, but I sure like them for comfort. This didn't have an underskirt originally, and it was the bodice was all in one piece, and they've remade that to make it into two, so it didn't wrinkle up so much with all the, you know, hip kicks, and so that it moves, the skirt and the bodice move independently of each other, and it's just not so much wrinkling and bagging, and no, it's my breastplate, and it lifts and separates. Carved by a wonderful Maori artist, Inia, and he did the design. And this is—it all means something. All this is Maori design, and it's to do with wahine, which is women and empowerment. And yeah, he designed this fabulous piece of art. We've been through dozens of them. The stunt girls wear ones made out of foam and that are painted bronze, and I wear this one, which is not so good for landing on, but we're changing them out these days. I get to wear a stunt one on the back so that when I have to do a landing on my back, not, you know, ruining the copper and B, ruining myself. And yeah, there you go. It's on your back. It's clipped on. It's clipped on to the laces. The little Xena knickers. Look, you know, you've got to have a little bit of the frilly stuff on your knickers, so that when you go, when you do all those high kicks, people don't just see a modern pair of underwear. You know, if Xena wore underwear, which undoubtedly she doesn't.
Xena and Virgil arrive in North Africa, where her plan is to be bought by Gurkhan at auction and become one of his wives. This will get her close enough to kill him, something she does not want Gabrielle to have to do.
It's comic.
Right. I'll have a look at the
thing. Yeah, that's fine, yeah.
I'll see him make it look good. You go, right. Can we do this?
Okay.
I am going to say that line there. Is that all right, Graham, with you?
Well, yeah.
It might be in it, yeah.
It will be, yeah, but that's okay.
So you look good, all right? Right, him shoved me forward. Not that good.
Okay.
And then he just goes to town.
The name is Sue.
Yeah. Whatever you say, Zena.
You can just put the wide shots. The one that get in their winch or something with a little bit more
forward winch.
Forward winch,
Flippy? Yep.
Level and
got it.
Yeah, just your line when you get in there. So we can just bring it up a wee bit.
Okay.
Probably putting a bit of a hubbub in the background anyway, so it'll sound quite...
You know what, right on action.
Okay.
Thank you.
Nice to meet you too.
Start here. Yes. And as soon as we go, not background, and then as soon as you get action, just walk straight through. So, what to run okay, yeah.
Gabrielle has followed Zena into the city. She persuades Virgil to bring her to Gurkhan as a gift, and in order to catch his eye, she offers to dance for him. Renee worked with Shauna McCullough, the choreographer, on this routine while they were shooting the dungeon scene with Lucy. I was frantically running back and forth trying to film both of them.
In the dance that we're doing for this episode, there's a lot of back bends and I'm gonna have like tweaks in my back if I don't sort of warm up and get ready for it. So I'm stretching, trying to strengthen it.
Ka-ching, ka-ching, ching, ching.
It stays down, doesn't it?
Yeah. In, and out. Ka-ching, 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 out, out. In, lovely. In, good. In, okay. Arms with the rib cage, T. This is where I do a little turn and peek back around. That's nice. Peek there. And then whip back around to go here, dropping it. And now here you get ready to do the flip over the back. Yep, so you want to actually, and I bring it around this way in your right hand. That's it. Now you've got the thin end.
So the right hand grabs it.
Here it goes floaty, floaty, floaty. Rappy, rappy, rappy. And now,
that's easy.
And you put.
While working on one episode, you have to start preparing for the next. It's 6:30 at night, and after a 12-hour day, Lucy and Renee join the read through for The Haunting of Amphipolis. Have you noticed they do a lot of eating at these sessions?
May I welcome you all to Zena Episode 3, The Haunting of Amphipolis. You've all been with us before, but I'll remind you that we read through scene by scene, and if you have any questions or comments at the end of each scene, please holler out. We're here to answer those questions or make it better if it is at all possible. At all possible. So normally we go around the room and introduce ourselves. I'm Eric playing one of the producers.
I'm Simon, the producer.
I'm Darian, I'm playing Cyrene.
Oh, Chloe, another producer.
Anthony Ray Parker, King of Hell.
Awesome.
Kath, script supervisor.
I'm Garth, the director.
I'm Adrian, I play Eve.
I'm Rob, one of the executive producers.
Lucy Eve.
Oh, no.
Gabrielle
Eve and Renee.
My goodness, it's going to be one of those evenings. Okay, everybody should be working up a pink script. Pink, pink, pink.
All pinks.
That's right.
All the time.
Garth, as always, holler out if there's anything that you want to say about things. And let's tackle it, shall we?
You know what? I have one comment before this all starts, and this is more a direction for Garth and Lucy and Renee, which is, this is a very atypical, I think, Zena episode, since it's Zena meets the Evil Dead.
Yeah. I've got some really good ideas of how to shoot that.
I bet you would.
We could put a camera on like a skateboard and roll it across the...
Mm-hmm.
Shaking cam, we'll call it.
Yeah, there
let's
you
do.
Go. Let's do that. And spin it if we can at the same time, and then we got ourselves an episode.
Mm.
All right.
So what sort of screen factor are we going for here? Like
A 9.4, I'd say.
Can you scream?
Can you scream?
Can't everyone?
I can.
Really?
Oh, you wouldn't probably.
No, I just can't scream.
Really?
Not if I want to.
Some people are good screamers.
I can scream.
You can scream,
Hudson,
right?
Hudson was a great
screamer.
It was
one of my first
screamer.
Jobs, I think, yeah.
Hudson was one
of your first
of
jobs as a screamer?
Yeah.
I don't know if we need to go any further than that, do we? We're now down in Amphipolis. And they're singing the anthem of Amphipolis, which I don't know offhand, but I'm sure you all do.
Simon, did we get that piece?
Yep.
Glee, my glee.
Darian, can you give us a little rendition of Glee, my glee?
Oh, yeah, I can't remember it.
Oh, come on. That kind of stuff stays with you.
I remember it went something like that. Mm-hmm.
All right. Well, we will have stuff for us on the day, if not before, so we can practice.
On the journey here, I kept thinking when I got home, I would finally have a chance to say all those things I never said. I thought we would finally have that heart-to-heart, put things behind us. I know I didn't follow the path you wanted for me, wandering all over the world, but I always carried you with me in my heart. A lot of hearts. And now it's too late for you to even see your beautiful granddaughter. I don't think that Xena is saying, you know, I wanted to say all those things.
Right.
I finally had said, since we were pretty much on the same page, but...
At Amphipolis.
Yes. What she would really want to say is she wants to know what had happened in the intervening 25 years. Mm. And I want to tell you that I wasn't dead. And then she can, maybe Xena will have that thought like, but I bet you knew that. You know, I bet you believed in me to the end. I don't know what, but does that...
Yep.
Mm-hmm. It's the first stage of a costume fitting.
Sometimes an actor isn't needed in a scene or two. You might think this is when they read War and Peace or knit that 7-foot scarf for Uncle Bill. The truth is, it's a perfect time for a costume fitting for the next episode.
Does it feel okay, Renee?
That feels great. It's very comfortable, yeah. These are the ladies who decide how short the skirts go. Shorter.
Sometimes we sort of go, oh, do you ever think so?
What happens is Beanie comes up with an idea, basically, from the director, from Rob, right?
Yeah.
On the costume. And then the costume is then... design. Oh, come here, come on, explain. How do you start? Like,
Well, we take into account what sort of action you have to do, you know, whether you have to be on the blue screen, any of that sort of thing.
So if it's blue screen, then you can't wear blue anywhere in the costume because then you blend in with the blue screen, right?
Yeah.
So then you have like holes. Which one is it? We were just talking about an episode where Gabrielle's supposed to be naked. Gets possessed.
I and saved it.
Katie here saved us. This is Jeanette. This is our team. And
hi.
Chandra. And these guys work all weekend, all night, if they have to. You know, there's no sort of...
No compromise.
Yeah, there's no compromise. Like, well, it's got to be ready for the episode. And, it's up to these guys to get it done.
Gabrielle's dance has caught the eye of Gurkhan. Xena, seeing that her partner has smuggled a knife into the harem, takes it away before the guards find out who it belongs to.
So you can actually, ooh, that really hurt, bang, why am I doing this? Yeah. Good.
I like the bit where Lucy hits herself with the stick to see if it's going to hurt.
I think what I'll do is that one. Probably
works for us. Hold the work, please, guys. And... action.
I got this covered. Xena, he's mine. What do you think they were gonna do? Sit still while you kill all three of them? And what about Sarah? Sorry to do this to you, Gabrielle.
She like that?
It was just funny, you're going with nobody there, and he goes, oh, shh. Excellent, that's a really interesting thing.
Did you
okay, let's just have a rehearsal. Yeah.
It's a timing thing, Michael.
I know. It just made me laugh.
Did you go in?
Yeah. Okay, I've got a rehearsal here, guys. Let's do it. And. Action!
It's under control.
Denise, mine.
And what about Sarah? Did you think of that? My plan will get us to Gurkhan. Trust me. Shh.
She won't have girl. She won't be first. What? She won't have. She won't have girl Khan before me. I'm sorry, you shank. Oh, boom.
As anyone who watches this show can see, the production values on Xena are extraordinary. Rob Gillies fills us in on the creative process involved in taking the show to North Africa.
So when Rob Tappert came to you and said, we're going to North Africa, what did you do?
Pack my bags. the first thing I did was think about it, go, okay, that's great. Why not? And get the script, read it, and then get some images in my head in, you know, tandem with Michael, who was going to direct it. So we come to this material that we're surrounding ourselves with, books like this one, Orientalism and Art, which is basically Victorian painting and the obsession that the Victorians had with what they thought was going on inside harems and such exotic places. You know, the main part of Ghur Khan's harem, his inner world, we've decided to set in one particular stage that we have. And I produce the hastily scribbled out drawings, which are in no way meant to be, you know,
final
works into themselves, but really my task is to very quickly disseminate some form of initial visual information about what it's going to look like. You know, I talk with Walker. Walker Atwell is the DOP. He's going to shoot this particular show. And we're just talking about, you know, the feel of it and how he's going to light it. He'll just light the actors and we'll let the spill light the set.
I think of Oriental as having textures, as having pillows, as having drapes, cushions, and that sort of thing.
In parts they are, and then in parts they're not. We'll go for it in specific places where we want it. You know, like his bed. We've decided that Ghur Khan's bedroom is all about the bed. There's a reference for his bed.
Ah, okay.
Yeah, it's in no way a bed, but we love this, you know, very funky, rich sort of male hangings to his bed, rather than a wispy, diaphanous sort of situation.
This show is a costume designer's delight, with exotic story locations and two actresses who would look good in modern wear, but are breathtaking in outfits created for this episode by Jane Holland.
When you knew you were doing this episode, and they were telling you we're going to North Africa, and there'll be harem pieces, and
well, it's sort of there's a mixture of influences. I mean, you know, we've got the North African thing, but really the harem influence is pretty much Oriental. So we looked at a lot of Orientalism reference paintings and things.
Use books and paintings. I was talking about
use all kinds of things, but yeah, use books, paintings, tribal reference. Fashion sometimes, it depends. Or, you know, it can be anything. It could be a piece of fabric. And that's the costume that she dances in. It's basically Gabrielle dressed in jewellery more than anything.
We haven't seen it all, so we're hoping to film that.
There's a lot of movement in that for the dance as well.
That's it. Oh, that's great. No, it is, because it makes a real difference if you just do that. It's actually the up and down. Yeah. That's it. And that makes the things rattle as well.
You may remember Rob saying he needed an episode with no fights. However, Gabrielle does get to take out a pesky harem wife. Check out the difference in Renee between the rehearsal and the actual shooting. You do not want to get in her way on a bad day.
Hair. Should we just like this? Right? Right. In backing or staying? Backing, yeah?
We'll make this here. One, two, three.
Two.
Yep.
Three.
Out there, we're out of shot. Probably
so,
past here.
So we'll do three or four of those, yeah, and then the last one, just by camera, she'll just hold her head. Boom! And that'll be it.
By the way, Renee is fighting with Lucy's stunt double, Zoe Bell.
I'm ready for everything. Actually, I ask them these days just not to tell me in advance. Sometimes they feel like they have to warn you, and some actors like that, I don't, because I just spend all week anticipating the worst or the best, and it takes a lot of energy, you know, fearing some terrible experience. It's much worse than just doing it on the day and not worrying about it.
You had a bucket of water thrown on you a couple of days ago in the dungeon.
Yeah, that was nice. That was kind of a new experience because it, yeah, I don't think that's ever happened. I mean, I've been wet, but to have a nice warm bucket of water was...
They warmed it before they threw it?
Yeah, I had to insist. I had to beg for it, though.
Here we go. Turn over.
Go in.
Three. 1520, take one. Mark in. Hey, camera.
It was pretty good.
Good.
Okay. That was okay, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, good.
Let's check
the gates.
Reloading.
Okay, moving on.
Camera.
And we're on a tight shot of Lucy.
Now we'll need, and we need Renee. What's right. Renee dressed up?
Dancing.
Whoops. Okay, well, I'll buy that then. We'll have to dance live.
I'll need Renee for the next shot, thanks.
Last time I wore this, I was so depressed.
Oh, no.
I was having such a bad day. And I was like in pain, I was sick, and I was, and I was like crying behind my sore eye. And all the tears were reacting with the glue, and I was just getting more miserable.
Oh.
You have bad days when you live on set. But that's a good thing because we're all kind of a family, so. Doesn't matter, you know. Try to set up a pernicious trend, like singing some really goofy song, and then everybody gets it in their head, sort of. Somebody else will do it. Well, Barry Manilow's songs are good, aren't they? Her name was Lola. Oh, Mandy. Because everybody's heard them, and they're so melodic, they just get stuck in your
abuse.
Lots more abuse.
We added a scene of Xena and Gabrielle that was in the dungeon, and it's Xena imagining Gabrielle coming to her in the dungeon. It was actually scripted as them riding on the beach, and we're still going to shoot that portion of it, but there was added bits and pieces because at the end of the day, we were hoping, Michael and myself and RJ, that this would play as kind of a strange love story, in as much as Xena has to go and bear the weight of that which she doesn't want Gabrielle to experience.
Going up, guys.
Okay. Team 21 Bravo, take one.
Hold up.
There's Mark on.
I love it. Okay.
Position four, blood. Put down silence to go. Directly underneath your hand there. And just pull it through a little bit.
Fell asleep.
Down there, please. Go here?
Yep, blood there, please.
Lots of blood, like the
blood.
Lots of,
yep.
Speed.
Oh, you've got it.
Cool. And start dripping above.
Would you believe they hung Lucy by her ankles on Monday and didn't take her down until a week from Tuesday? Which is to say, they shot this scene and the following one a week apart.
Okay.
Stand by.
And be rolling. And whoa.
And just watch your toe, please. I've got your foot. Step.
Action.
So once more off the head, I caught you, Craig, as we're coming out.
Action.
Are you here simply because you were taken as a slave?
No. I want to be here.
Really? And why is that?
I want to give myself to the great God.
Are you sure? No other agenda?
Yes, Roy.
I'm listening.
I want to be number one wife.
You're very strong.
I am strong. Feel that. You're fishing, aren't you? Oh, you are like
my magnificent abs.
Look at you go.
Michelle, probably your crossover to this side.
My ab.
I'll say they're looking pretty good.
I had a bit of a chocolate and cheese feast last week. I ate everything.
You get that?
Heaps.
Get into it.
Someone says, you know that you have to do something, you know you have to look good, so you just start chowing down.
Even when the pressure's on.
You can have chips and cheese and chicken skin. Chocolate. Yeah.
1 minute you're hanging upside down by your ankles, next minute you're giggling with your colleagues. This is not your typical work day, unless you happen to work on Xena.
Every time I get a prosthetic device, I wrap it up in a little box and send it to our old cameraman. He's working down in Wellington at the moment, and he should right about now be receiving on his seat my eye from the other day. They're so old and gnarly and disgusting, covered in blood, and I always get a chop bit of hair and put a bit of hair in it, put it in a little box, and he's such a sucker for a present. He always thinks it's from a secret admirer.
Once she gave him a wart that they'd put on her face, and she took it off and the hair was still stuck in and wrapped it nicely.
He thought it was from his girlfriend.
Yeah.
He's like, oh, wow, that's sweet.
He's a total sucker.
Until he opened it up. Yeah. And
doesn't matter where he goes, he gets my nasty old bodily cast off my wounds.
You may notice Michael is wearing a dress. I'll let you ponder that a while, and Lucy will explain later. I promise.
Yeah, because that means that's my close angle. And then as soon as you turn this way, I'll go jump wide. Then you wait till she's got to where she's going to be standing and about to stop. Everything will have stopped. And say it's there, and then at that moment, both of you go, let's go. And you both disappear. And I can cue you when they've disappeared, if you like.
Righty ho.
For you to fall. In fact, I'll cue guards, take a beat, and fall.
Let's have a look. Xena comes in. Two. Hold it there. Now, as Xena starts moving, you move. Off we go together. Everybody moving.
Walking.
And go, guards. And Lucy. And off you go. That's it. And then you can be right by camera. That's good. Too close, I believe.
No, we didn't set it twos. We'll do that now.
That's good, that's perfect.
Action. Is she alright?
Peachy. Can you say that line again?
Yeah. Over there. Is she alright?
Peachy. Sometimes to let off a little bit of steam, we have theme days, and today's frock day, which is our most common theme day, and everybody comes and they have to wear something glam. So as you see, Michael's in a dress. Michael has gone the whole hog, and he's even got a beret in there. And being an actor, when you put on a costume, you become a character, and sometimes you'll see Michael gaily tripping down the halls or something. But yeah, everybody's got their best dresses on today.
The first thing everyone said when I came home and started showing this footage in the office was, I can't believe how much work it takes. When all you see are the actors on screen, you can't imagine the amount of people and the number of hours it takes to put it all together.
Thinking about Sarah?
Yes. And mother and father. Didn't get a chance to say goodbye to them, Zena. I don't think Sarah's here. I've asked.
She's here. Believe it.
Zena has decided to give Gabrielle the chance to kill Gurkhan. Watch as what seems to be an intimate moment between the two characters is invaded by the camera and crew sliding in on the left like a long-necked dragon.
You can kill Gurkhan. Don't thank me. Just be ready.
Good. Drift off. Love it. Oh, I love it. And that's great. That's going to work really well. Very nice.
So in this episode, who's Gurkhan? I gather Zena's going to have some body decoration?
Yeah, we've come up with a design that's sort of inspired by the North African traditional sort of body art. We've sort of done our own version, which is in a darker sort of ink colour, which we've got here with the fingernails and a sort of very linear type North African design.
Lucy's forever telling us she's uncoordinated. I don't believe it. She learned this routine in the dark corners of the set, and you can even see Shona marking it out for her while she's going through final checks. Certainly the women fanning themselves at the end thought she did a good job. Heaven only knows how Gurkhan felt when it was over.
outrageous he does. Dance when I can have sex to music.
Okay.
Shut up, sweetie.
I really wanted to find a new way to not be able to kill the man. So we talked about it quite extensively, and his approach is wonderful. It's very proactive. Gabrielle makes a decision not to kill. It's not because she can't, but she thinks that it's better for her not to. You know, it's rather than being defeated by it, it's an actual, it's actually quite a positive thing, you know?
Or is it?
I like it
with a strike.
Yeah. That's what I like. Because yeah, then you can literally, and when we do, then you can just, and you can go until you're sick with not being able to do anything.
Okay, so on this bit, I go ka-ching, ka-ching. But just obviously not hitting him. But how much do you want me to do? Just time out of breath. Okay. Do you want me to like really go as far as I can? Because I can go for a while.
All right. Fine. This angle. I'll have something to cut between you on this angle.
So then keep going until I can. You're okay to burn and all that stuff. Okay, great.
We have to.
If I kill you, you win.
Girls, we're going on a cruise. Anyone care to come?
Lucy and Rob were always saying to me, the day really ends when that awful brown stuff goes down the drain. So we filmed it.
Oh, that's a wrap, thank God for that. All right, come on, Ren, I'll give you all the time.
Hey, Madge. Give me your open girl.
It's your new car.
Yep.
Right.
Now I'm the sixth season, I can finally
afford something to drive.
Decent. Yeah. Warm her up a little.
And away we go.
Off for a hot weekend.
Woo-hoo.